Many people, including myself, have trouble exercising in cold weather. So, you know, you go outside, you know, for a run in the freezing cold, and the cold air causes you to have coughing fits, or perhaps you get a sore throat. If that happens to you, you're not alone. Many of us have the same problem. In fact, it's estimated that anywhere from 4 to 20% of people have this complaint. The actual cause of it has not always been agreed upon, but for many years the prevailing theory was that this was caused by exercise-induced bronchoconstriction, or EIB, and that is a narrowing of the airways that's much like an asthma attack, but in this case is brought on by cold air. Now, EIB is, of course, common in people with asthma, and it's actually sometimes called exercise-induced asthma. However, many of the sufferers of EIB have no history of asthma. And EIB is also more common in children and young adults. In fact, I used to get severe sore throats from running in the cold when I was young, and that doesn't happen to me now that I'm older. And it's hard to say why that is. The higher incidence of EIB in the young may simply relate to their higher levels of physical activity. That makes sense. I used to run everywhere when I was a kid. I never stopped running. And the symptoms of it, just so you know what I'm talking about, it includes wheezing or shortness of breath, feeling of tightness in your chest, and hypoxia, which is just not getting enough oxygen, being out of breath. Sometimes, however, the only symptom is a cough and a sore throat, you know, like I was talking about before. EIB theory has been the main theory for many years, but it's been debated. Now, EIB claims that it's the cold that causes the problem, but others have claimed that it's the dryness of the air, not the coldness, that causes the problem. You know, when it gets very, very cold outside, the air becomes very dry. Perhaps this dries out the airways and irritates them, leading to the symptoms. A study in the journal Chest by Kenneth Rundle and others tested this idea by using dry, medical-grade bottled air at both cold and room temperature. So they had 22 people with suspected EIB exercise while using this air. Turns out the temperature of the air didn't cause a heightened response. So the researchers concluded that moisture loss due to the air was the cause of the problem, due to the dry air. So the cells of the airways are very sensitive to dehydration. Now I'll link that study below in the description. If the cold, dry air is drying out the cells of your airway and causing this coughing or sore throat or tight chest or other symptoms, the question, of course, is should I be worried? You know, should I avoid exercising in the cold in case I'm going to do permanent damage? Well, unless the problem is very severe, it's not really going to hurt you, and you can finish your workout, your run, out in the cold, without fear your lungs are going to be permanently damaged. Rundle also suggested that there may be some homemade solutions, you know, like you could wear a moistened scarf or other cloth around the mouth to hydrate the incoming air. Now, this sounds terrible to me out in the cold, but maybe for somebody who must train for their sport in the cold and is having this problem, it's necessary. I can't see casual exercisers doing that. There are also, you know, masks that could be worn. Again, wearing a mask out in the cold while you exercise sounds terrible to me, but for some people, maybe. Medications for severe problems could also be used. You know, but athletes like skiers and runners, they may need to consider the state of legality for steroid asthma meds or inhalers or similar medications. You know, the legality in their sport. But the take-home, though, is that unless your symptoms are very severe, you're okay to just go ahead and exercise out in the cold and consider the symptoms when they do occur to be an irritating inconvenience, but not much more. I do want to remind you, though, that this should not be taken as medical advice. I'm just giving you the information to the best of my ability that we have. But anytime you have symptoms or you have doubts about whether you should exercise, you should always consult your doctor and get his or her take on it before you do go out and run or ski or what have you in the cold.